USA. And this is only a very small part of the huge corn meat belt, an area almost 20 times the size of Belgium. As in many other parts of the United States, it's these straight roads that immediately catch the eye. Agriculture in Iowa is primarily concerned with the buying, feeding, and selling of livestock. These eternally waving wheat fields show the rolling quality of farmland in the Great Plains. And this quality is why so many farmers use the technique of contour plowing. Grains play a vital role. Farmers here often employ a system of crop rotation. In one year, for example, a farmer might sow oats. After the oats are harvested, he'll plant alfalfa the next year. As in other parts of the United States, agriculture in Iowa is very highly mechanized and expensive. Here, soybeans are weeded. This very rich crop is used first for the feeding of cattle. Farmers no longer make compressed bales from mowed and dried hay. Instead, they make large rolls with diameters of nearly 7 feet. It's a quicker process. The metal ring around the hay roll keeps the animals from stepping in the food they'll eat. There are not many dairies in Iowa, but the working methods are the same as in Belgium. Yeah. dairy farm, there are some 150 cows, and virtually everything is done mechanically. The product is then transported to the dairy. In the United States is not like a small Belgian farm. It has a large complex of buildings. Typical is the geometrical split up of parcels of land, which results in the square mile pattern. And again, there are these endless straight roads running to the horizon. More and more farmers are growing alfalfa, a kind of clover with a very high nutritive value. Each crop has a large quantity of vitamins, minerals, and protein. These huge harvesting machines are cutting the plants, and the crop is immediately transported to the dehydrating factory. Of the moisture is removed from the plant in this factory by a quick drying process. But the high nutritive value is retained. Then the alfalfa is compressed into small pellets and stored. In the winter, the dried alfalfa is used as feed. Fresh alfalfa is the main feed during the summer. It is the most efficient crop for transforming plant protein into animal protein. Soybeans, hay, alfalfa, a lot of feeding crops, but there's more. The most important crop in the great corn meat belt is the corn itself. The local seed corn factories operate on a strict, scientific basis to produce new seed. Two kinds of corn are planted next to each other, two rows of one kind, six rows of the other, and so on. tassels are removed, avoiding self-pollination. By this forced open pollination, new hybrids are bred. These seeds will produce very high yields. After the machines come the hand laborers. The last tassels and studded ears are removed. Most of the work is performed by students, although they have to be 16 or older. They work a minimum of 8 hours a day with 3 breaks. In this killing heat, sometimes 104 degrees in the shade, taking a break is welcome. Corn harvested last year is now being shelled. Some will be kept for use on this farm, some will be sold. Corn that will be exported is stored in these bins. This shipment is going to St. Louis. It'll then be transported by barge down the Mississippi to New Orleans, where it'll be loaded on a freighter. The Corn Belt delivers grain to almost everywhere in the world. Test plots in many locations. Here, new corn hybrids are produced in the never-ending effort to improve yields. Pollen of a certain corn is used for crossbreeding with another. It isn't enough to increase the yield, though. The soil must also be protected, otherwise production will decline. On a farm with single crop planting and strong mechanization, there's another problem: topsoil runoff. The Soil Conservation District organizes guided tours for farmers to show how soil conservation is accomplished and how it's not accomplished. The modern approach requires good management to guarantee a decent income for the farmer. So the successful farmer needs all the latest information about cost, production, and yield.
Go down on top of this terrace here, and we can
Mrs.
see
her. Oh,
here's the terrace.
Who owns
Eddie Keaton's
brother-in-law?
Oh, yeah. You see the terraces?
There are different ways to avoid soil erosion. Here in Iowa, terraces are constructed on the steeper hills. It requires a lot of money, but the terraces stop the topsoil runoff, and the water is collected in ponds. Water can then be used for irrigation. Other techniques for avoiding erosion are strip cropping and contour plowing. The land is divided into long strips, and the farmer alternates, for example, corn, alfalfa, and again corn and alfalfa. The goal of all of this continuous education, of course, is to make farmers as scientifically informed as possible. The result is achieving the highest possible yields. Here then is the livestock auction, the final purpose of the corn meat belt. Calves are brought here from the far west to be fattened in Iowa. In fact, all of farming in Iowa is aimed at feeding livestock, transforming plant protein into animal protein.
Over here,
Nine and a half,